Hey folks, Odd here. Just wanted to show you guys something real quick. Comet 2012 S1, C2012 S1 ISON. When it comes in, I just wanted to show you how close it gets to Mars. See this? It's like right on top of Mars. Now the crazy thing about this is with it being on Mars like that, when it comes down, shouldn't Mars change its trajectory, or its orbital trajectory, further south? Say for instance, if it's coming in at this angle, it should kick it south. If it does kick it south, it will go around like this instead. So now, keep an eye on how far down south that's going to be. Now watch this. Now it's over Earth. So instead of being 0.042 astronomical units away, ISON could be even closer. Mars going to affect ISON's orbital path? Also, with it bringing in all this trash? I guess we'll see. Much love. God bless. We'll be right back. Folks, Odd here, just wanted to give you a quick update on the magnetic north shifting by 40 miles a year might signal pole reversal. Magnetic north is moving very rapidly and quickly towards Russia. Actually, it's already in Russia, which is why you will see that we are having extreme weather changes here on Earth is another factor. And another key factor showing of Nibiru's arrival, KBO. The magnetic north is currently shifting at a faster rate than at any time in human history, almost 40 miles a year. Some experts believe that it may be the beginning of a complete pole reversal. There you go, folks. You know, just craziness. You know, the KBO's out there, Earth showing signs, our weather showing signs, earthquakes, volcanic eruption. You know, we're having this pole shift. The sun's even acting towards it. You notice we have less spots on the Earth-facing side, on the Earth-facing disk of the sun. Most of the sunspots are actively on the other side, which is where the KBO is coming from. There you go, folks. I just wanted to go ahead and let you guys know, give you guys this update. Much love. God bless.
Residents, the businesses are also without power. We're in a Dunkin' Donuts parking lot right now. It is completely without lights. There's a mobile across the street, a gas station across the street. That's without power at this time.
Direct hit on Kansas this morning after dumping nearly 2 feet of snow in parts of Texas and leaving drivers stranded in Oklahoma. This is video playing out. Again, 5 deaths are now being blamed on this storm. Winds whipping fires actually across the state of Texas, including one that killed a mother and her twins in San Antonio. In just a moment, Sam's going to tell us where the storm is now.
Unbelievable. February snow. Late February snow in Charlotte. You gotta look. Whoa! Whoa! Holy smokes!
Juarez, Mexico. And there we are. We have snow on the ground, and it is currently snowing right now.
Notice that the highest ones are here in northeastern Illinois and northern Indiana. That's the bullseye from the storm. These are all additional over what you've already seen. Then we head toward the mid-Atlantic. Winter storm warnings are up for Martinsburg. Frederick County, Maryland was added to this morning. Charlottesville also under the winter storm warning, and around Elkins, West Virginia. Baltimore and D.C., you're under a winter storm watch. They have not upgraded yet, and here's why.
We're here along Hull Shore Drive in the town of Hull. This is Nantasket Beach behind me. And believe it or not, where you see that roiling ocean outside this morning, that is usually a wide, long beach that people come out and enjoy during the summertime. Obviously, today that is not the case. Overwash coming over, filling up the road. This is an impassable road at this point, and we're not the only ones dealing with a scene like this morning. They head all up and down the shore, along the most prone areas, Scituate, over into Plymouth, Sandwich. These are all areas where you've got local roads inundated with water as high tide, as we've been expecting, is the worst that we've seen from this particular winter storm.
A heavy blizzard has killed 8 people in Hokkaido, northern Japan. In Nakashibetsu town, a woman and her 3 children, aged from 11 to 17, were found dead in a car that was buried in snow. Firefighters responded to a call about people trapped in a car. They found them in a state of cardiorespiratory arrest. The four were confirmed dead at a hospital.
This is Skyu. This winter it has received more than 5.5 meters of snow, the most ever recorded anywhere in Japan.
Well, I've tried to get my tape measure all the way to the top and I failed, so instead I'm going to put it to here. That there is 2 meters, so that's 2 meters to there. So, you know, you can just see that that's at least 5.5 meters, maybe more.
There is a serious question to be asked here. Why is Japan getting all this snow? It may be a one-off, or it could be the result of global warming. Whichever, some of the effects are mind-boggling.
This might just look like an enormous pile of snow, but right underneath me here is a house.
And we're going to turn to Lita Olmsted. She's lived near the Sleeping Bear Dunes National Lakeshore in Michigan for nearly 7 years, but the Northern Michigan woman says that she's never seen anything like this. Let's show you the pictures. This is what Lita found on her walk one day, dozens of ice boulders scattered on the water's edge right there on Lake Michigan. So Lita is here this morning to join us via Skype. Thanks so much for joining us. We find this so fascinating. Describe what you saw there.
Basically, they were just giant, perfectly round balls of ice that were bigger than basketballs, some of them like beach ball size.
Have you ever seen anything like this before?
No, I've never seen anything like it. And most of the people who have lived here their whole life said they've never seen anything like it either, so it's really cool.
Now, did you go up and touch them? Were they heavy? Did you try to lift them?
Yeah, one of the pictures, I'm trying to lift it up, and I can't even budge it at all. It may be frozen, but I'm pretty sure they're probably like 75 pounds. So.
Wow.
I'm on the South Shetland Islands here in Antarctica. The temperature? 45 degrees. Now, one of the first things you'll notice after those cute penguins, those are gentoos and chinstraps, is the stunning lack of ice. While the National Oceanic Atmospheric Administration has measured a 31% decrease in ice at the North Pole, here in Antarctica, the story is somewhat muddled. In some spots, the ice is retreating, and that is not good for certain penguins.
The raging bushfires that have swept across Australia continue to spread, and strong winds and record temperatures fan the flames. Firefighters are still battling 130 fires across New South Wales, 40 of which...
my phone's about to die anyway. I don't want to be out here with no phone. So there it is again, hear that?
Tucson Electric Power were all negative. As the mystery continues, Tucsonans describe what they heard.
Yeah, no, I pulled up to his apartment and I heard just this like weird sound, and I told him that, you know, it sounded like something was like getting bombed outside, and then it was like not big enough for that. So I guess I heard it, but that's really cool. I wonder where this is from.
She just said that she heard a series of booms, and then I was like, you're crazy.
But it turns out there's something to it.
Yes, apparently.
Sunday, January 13th, 6:15 p.m. Chautauqua County Dispatch is inundated with calls about a loud boom shaking houses and rattling nerves across the southern part of the county. Viewers in Jamestown, Lakewood, Busty, Kennedy, Delavan, Asheville, and elsewhere told News 4 the deep rumbling noise sounded like thunder, cannons firing, or an explosion.
Mysterious lights hovering in the skies across several parts of the country. This video is from Indianapolis of a strange formation that appeared this week. Now, people in Metro Detroit say they've seen something just like it. Last night, our newsroom and our Facebook page got several reports of strange lights in the skies over Metro Detroit.
That enormous sinkhole that opened up under a house in Florida, swallowing a man in his bed. Crews are starting work again on this house that could collapse at any moment. And ABC's Gio Benitez is on the scene for us in Sefner, Florida.
The bedroom floor just collapsed, and my brother-in-law is in there. He's underneath the house.
Bush's brother desperately trying to save him.
I jumped in the hole and was trying to dig him out. I couldn't find him. I just started digging and started digging and started digging in it. The cops showed up and pulled me out of the hole and told me the floor was still falling in.
Hey guys, Top News 7. We have yet another sinkhole that has opened up, and this time it has swallowed a man, Mark Mahel. He was on a golf course in Illinois.
Hello, YouTube. Well, y'all have all seen this about the sinkhole, seen. My comments are still the same. And now I got backing on the same thing. I'm going to let you look at this as a little clip that's coming up. People, please, if you live anywhere close to this place, get out while you can. You ain't been told the whole truth about everything yet. You do know that there's a little bit of a, we found out today that there's a volcano underneath too. Well, not underneath that, but in the Gulf. It's lying asleep. Maybe somebody woke it up.
Finally some honesty. Finally some honesty.
People living in Bayou Corn are ready to take action.
For us, it's destroyed. It destroyed our family life. Our little piece of, the American dream is gone.
For them, the chaos started on August 3rd when the earth opened up
cypress trees fell over and were sucked into the water. But that was the result of something bigger that had started months earlier when police on a boat ride first noticed bubbling in the bayou.
Show you these amazing pictures from Mount Etna. Now, it's been erupting over the last couple of weeks and it's been sending plumes of ash flying into the air.
They found were erupting at the same time, just over 100 miles apart, and they used a special camera and created an amazing virtual volcano.
Я сейчас подойду, подождите.
Я себе.
These are some photos taken by a very alert guy named Bob Marino. He says he was in Santa Rosa watching a girls' varsity soccer game at Cardinal Newman High School when he saw this thing streak across the sky at a low altitude, followed by a loud boom. Tonight, a rare sight was seen across the sky. An NBC 6 viewer was in the right place at the right time when a meteor was passing overhead. This is video of that meteor as it happened. And reports of similar sightings happened all across the state, from Jacksonville all the way down to Key West.
Now, Mary, do we know for sure if this was a meteor?
You know, right now it's unclear whether it was a meteor or space junk. Either way, it was some type of debris that caused a spectacular sight in the sky. Now, with today's meteor along with the Russian meteor, it has a lot of people wondering just what is going on.
We have three comets that are going to be visible this year. 2013 is going to go down as the year of comets for us. There is a comet already out there. Guess what its name is? Comet Lemon. It was discovered by Mount Lemmon Sky Survey, part of the University of Arizona's astronomy program up on top of the mountain. It's coming to the northern hemisphere. It will be visible to us in April. Right now it's in the southern hemisphere sky. Here's a picture of it. It's got a little faint tail coming off. It is surprising astronomers by being much brighter than they thought it would be. This is actually through a telescope, so even in the southern hemisphere, they can't see it with their naked eye yet, but that will change. This comet is made up, of course, of a ball of ice and rocks, and the gases that are coming off of it when the ice sublimates as solar radiation hits it from the sun, it's cyanogen and diatomic carbon. Why do we care about that? Makes it glow green. A green comet, not all that common for us. Where's this comet coming from? You know, it only visits the Earth, they think, every 11,000 years. So we're going to be very lucky to see this one. It's 100,000 times the distance from the sun to the Earth, from us, way out there. And that's why it takes 11,000 years to make that cycle around the sun.
A rare comet makes its debut in the northern hemisphere, visible to the naked eye. It will give you the best view you could have in years. In fact, some astronomers are calling 2013 the year of the comet as they identify more and more of these snowballs flying through space. Does it, though, raise questions about our safety here on Earth?
Comets will be making a big return in 2013, with two scheduled to pass within the year. The first dazzling display of a giant hunk of ice and gas hurtling through space will begin on March 13th. The Pan-STARRS comet will be able to be seen on the western horizon in the northern hemisphere. Another stunning comet, dubbed Icen, will be making its appearance in November, as it's likely to dive into the sun in a blaze of glory.
Late this year, there's a new comet that's going to blaze across the sky. Experts say Ison is going to be dazzling. That is late November. The brilliance lighter, brighter than the full moon.
Hello, YouTube. Scum and Eye Disclosure here. I wanted to show you this alleged first video of comet 2012 Ison. So I'm getting this off spaceweather.com. That's supposed to be it right there, almost below the center. And as you can see, it looks like it has two companions with it. January 20th, 2013, posted. This just in. It's too early to confirm, but some initial data suggests that comet C2012-S1 Ison has at least one companion and possibly up to seven.
It's still only a month into 2013, and already Australia has been hit by a record heat wave, devastating wildfires, and an unprecedented deluge of sea foam. And as if that weren't enough, then came the floods, which have ravaged towns and businesses along the country's east coast over the last week.
Torrential rain is continuing to cause flooding in central and northern Queensland. Several towns along the coast have been isolated. Floodwaters have cut more than 70 roads, including the state's major highways.
Thank you.
Fisheries experts are investigating what caused the death of thousands of fish on the Eyre Peninsula. The juvenile leather jackets have washed up along a 10-kilometre stretch of beaches south of Port Neal over the last week.
Absolutely incredible. I've never seen a fish kill like it in all my time travelling around the countryside.
Authorities believe unusually strong winds over several days may have caused the mass kill in the remote coastal area. Samples of the fish have been taken and a cause of death should be known within days.
Fears that the H1N1 virus has now mutated and resembles the Spanish flu virus that killed more than 50 million people at the beginning of the 20th century. Ukrainian doctors say the lungs of the victims are as black as charcoal.
Sounding the alarm about nightmare superbugs in our hospitals, now in 42 states, highly contagious, deadly, and drug resistant. We'll have the new warning tonight. We now turn to health news tonight. New and extremely dangerous super germs that are showing up in hospitals across this country, other healthcare facilities, prompting some strong and alarming language from the CDC. We get our report tonight from our chief medical editor, Dr. Nancy Snyder.
It's a silent threat lurking inside our nation's hospitals. A deadly class of superbugs that's nearly impossible to treat.
It's resistant to virtually all antibiotics. So when an individual gets this microbe and it invades the blood or invades tissue, curing them becomes very difficult.
Reports of dense smog and toxic air in China have been making headlines this week. Many are outraged at dangerous levels of pollution. It wasn't created overnight, though, and here are some of the factors behind China's smog problem.
The smog and haze that has been covering some of China's biggest cities reached alarming levels this week. Local authorities admit the pollution is severe. Environmentalists say it's been years in the making.
You can see the water spot right here. It's over Hillsborough Bay. That's right adjacent to Tampa.
Are you serious? What? Something biblical is going on with the signs of the second coming of Christ. Now that is some biblical hail.
Quarter of a mile from our location here on Highway 41 near I-75. This funnel is about to cross the interstate here in Adairsville. Again, we've been tracking the storm. We've got debris now flying to the left and center of this system. The sirens have been going off here. The wind is kicking up along with the rain. Again, a funnel just crossing the interstate here in Adairsville.
A big problem, and it's kind of a gross one too. Genetically mutated rats. Army snipers are going out at night hunting these things. An environmental expert says he thinks they're growing so big because they've been exposed to radiation and chemicals.
Whether you're on a downtown stroll, eating lunch outside, or playing golf, this summer you have a new friend to look out for. The state considered by many to have the most bugs is about to get a new tenant, a mosquito 20 times the size of the one you're used to that feeds day and night and has a sting some say feels like a poke from a knife.
Welcome to Arctic America. After weeks of some of the mildest seasonal weather in recorded history, a bracing blast of winter is sweeping a broad swath from the American Midwest to the New England coast, freezing waterfalls in Massachusetts and giving New York street vendors a chance to cash in on the cold.
Gloves, hats, scarves, earmuffs, selling very good.
High winds and heavy snows shredded the roof of Detroit's Silver Dome. Here in Chicago, on the coldest morning in 2 years, police rescued a dog trapped on a frozen harbor. The coldest temperatures dipped to 35 below zero in Minnesota. Wind chills make it feel like 40 below across much of the northern United States.
It's just going to be a quick video here. There was another meteor asteroid that flew over South Africa, I think, last night sometime. Cape Canaveral. An asteroid as big as a city block shot relatively close by the Earth on Saturday.
And also have sunspots that are disappearing, which is not a good thing. Now, the sunspots that are disappearing, as you can see here, is causing a magnetic drop on the sun's magnetic field and on our own Earth's magnetic field. Not good. We actually need these solar flares to strengthen our magnetic field and hold our atmosphere steady. And our atmosphere is also shrinking.
I was in the passenger side of this fucker's car, and he comes over on there. He was over by the recycling center. He says, "Oh, when I was in the Virgin Islands, 30 years old on a business trip, I fucked this 14-year-old." I was like, "You what?" He's like, "I raped this 14-year-old." Starts crying, gives me a big hug. He's like, "Fuck, 300-pound guy." I'm like, "Oh shit, you must be fuckered, man. Like, what's he talking about?" I didn't take him seriously at first. Comes driving down this way. He's like, "You know what? I come to realize I'm Jesus Christ, and I can do anything I fucking want to." And watch this, bam, and he smashed into this fucking guy right there, pinned him in between that fucking truck.
We'll show you some extraordinary pictures which came to us from the Vatican on what was, of course, an extraordinary day. Within hours of Pope Benedict announcing that he was to resign, take a look at this. Lightning struck St. Peter's Basilica. You can see it again now in slow motion.
The Catholic Church has its first ever non-European Pope, Jorge Mario Bergoglio of Argentina, now Pope Francis.
In an interview with us in September, he declared,
"I do greater things than Jesus of Nazareth, much greater."
Now, sporting his new tattoos,
"Saints, saints, saints, triple S." Huh?
De Jesus says those expecting the second coming of Christ on a cloud with angels have misinterpreted what Jesus himself said.
He said it. "You won't see me anymore because he will come in another body, which is me."
We'll be right back.
But for some reason, they perpetuate this myth that comets are dirty snowballs. The one last point is that we are now aware of a very large object that is coming into the solar system, and there seems to be a historical recurrence of this object. Some people call it Nibiru, Planet X. My personal study deals with what I call extrasolar system objects. Some are big, some are small, but there's no question that there are hundreds, possibly thousands of these objects which come into our solar system periodically and then go out in a long orbit. Some may have a 100,000-year orbit. We saw one last February 2003, which we now call Comet Neat B1, which had a 33,000-year orbit, a very large object that came very near the sun, was tremendously large and affected the sun. This is the other thing, is that comets have the ability to affect the energy output of the sun. When that happens, we then get severe weather on Earth. So there's many aspects to the effects that these large comets can have on the solar system and on planet Earth. But the bottom line is, comets are not dirty snowballs. They are a very energetic plasma interaction of an asteroidal rocky body with the solar electric field. Very complex topic, and for some reason, one that, like I say, is very much now accepted in the upper tiers of science, the what I call the secret science in the United States and with scientists around the world. I should mention also that as early as the mid-1990s, my work had been translated into Russian and is being taught as the top-level science in Russia today regarding comets, the electrical nature of the solar system, yet it is hardly even known about in the Western Hemisphere. So now what I want to show you are the comets coming in from the south. And if you've seen my homepage, I've got dozens and dozens of these. I picked a couple just to show you. And look down in this region where I've got the mouse arrow coming up. There it comes. You see it? Boom. The sun explodes. Now, according to NASA, that's a half a mile wide little ice ball. Do you think that that's causing the sun to explode the way it does? And it's a little ice ball? Well, according to those people, that explosion is just coincidence. How many of these do you have to see until you realize that it's not coincidence? Comets are electrically...
This is the flare. Whoops, I'm sorry, whoops.
I jumped ahead just a little bit here. There's a kind of a thing on the side of this mouse I keep hitting. Let's go back to this. Okay, right here, the first comet coming in misses that flare. The second comet comes in and directly hits it, and this is the result. NASA says coincidence. That big flare, the biggest flare we've ever seen in the solar system. We know from historical records that there at least was one big object that came by Earth a long time ago. I'll just, instead of using years or thousands of years, because the Earth shows us that it has very tremendous changes that have gone on very rapidly. And modern science is striving desperately to use standard processes to explain this.
Hello, YouTube. Scum and Audio Disclosure here. I wanted to show you this alleged first video of Comet 2012 ISON. So I'm getting this off spaceweather.com. That's supposed to be it right there, almost below the center. And as you can see, it looks like it has two companions with it. Now this is the first video right here that's been on the internet that has been taken of this comet. Now Professor James McCanney posted this over on his website, and I want to read it here. Hope he doesn't mind. January 20th, 2013, posting. This just in. It's too early to confirm, but some initial data suggests that Comet See 2012 S1 Ison has at least one companion and possibly up to seven. When something like this happens, one has to be very cautious, but after examining the data that I've seen, I would say that it appears to be real.
But,
what would you say for him that he can't say then?
I think the comet is the big threat, and they don't want anything said about that. They want to keep a lid on it because of the chaos it will develop, because people will realize that they're wasting their time in their endeavors, and that they should be preparing. My belief is you should be preparing spiritually now. We're at the end of a long course here. Earth is completely off track. And as I've told you in my emails, the cosmos is organic and an immune response is coming.
Hey folks, welcome to Code Searcher. Listen, somebody sent me a video of Paul Bagley. He did something on Ison here recently, the comet. They reminded me that even though I covered Ison over at Livestream, what's been months now, I needed to do it over in YouTube. What I have here is wormwood, and what I want to show you is a connection to Ison and Revelation 8:8. I'm going to do a series of three videos cross-confirming each axis term. One axis term will be wormwood, one axis term will be comet 2012 S1, which is Ison. And the third will be Michael Drosnin's comet table from his book. And I've been looking for this comet he's talked about for years. For those that you know me, know I've been doing this. And only recently, when Ison was identified, have I been able to make a connection to Michael Drosnin's doomsday comet table. And I will show you his expanded version of that table. And it's not good, folks. It spells out complete disaster. But here in this table, what I wanted to show you, again, we have the axis term wormwood. Sorry about that. Here in the blue, we have the famine. The famine is there. Also, at the top, we have harbinger, and it's there twice. It's there at a skip of, I believe, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, skip of 12. So there's 12 letters between letters. And then a skip of 1, which is in the plain text. Right here in the blue is the comet. And here we have Revelation crossing over the axis term. Now here the red, or the pink, is the word for calamity, or bitterness, or poison. Runs this way. And this is interesting. The Lord woke me up. You know, I was thinking about words to run in this table, and I remembered someone asking me to look for the rapture. Here it is. Rapture's there in the green. Down here in the bottom of the blue, I mean the brown, is the word for, or the words for, blood water. Blood water. Here in the plain text, I've highlighted just a few verses, just some things that I've seen. I thought might have been significant. I haven't translated all of the text and looked at everything so far, but I will revise this when I do. Here we have the next Sabbath. Right here it talks about, well, let's talk about this first. Right here it talks about the sins of the people, and how's it go? Bear the sins and will die childless. They will bear their sins and die childless. And right here we have the harvest. when I get the rest of the plain text translated and looked at it real thorough, I'll give you the rest of it. But so far, let me show you this. Ison is here as well. The common name Ison. Here it is. Aleph Nun Yud Bet Nun. And just to show you that, I want to go over to Google and show you Ison, I-S-O-N. And over here we have Aleph Nun Bet. Excuse me. Aleph Nun Yod Bet Nun. Aleph Nun Yod Bet Nun. Ison. Also, which is really interesting, I have this on a row skip of two. You see how there's two rows in between? Which, so at this width, it's 1,222. But if you take it down to the original width, folks, times this by 3, you get 3,666. If I find anything else in this table, I'll make another video and revise it. Be looking for two, for the next two. They all three confirm one another. This is definitely the comet I've been looking for. It is definitely connected to Wormwood. I'm not saying that it is Wormwood, but they are connected. You know, this comet is apparently pulling a lot of garbage and trash behind it. So, you know, what happens when it gets here? Well, you'll see in the other tables. It's not going to be good. It's definitely a harbinger, like it says up here. And then
Now, that meteor was only about 55 feet long. Experts say the chances of a major catastrophe from the meteor are slim, but of course they're very real now. They say there's roughly 10,000 small meteors floating around within range of Earth, all of those capable of destroying a major U.S. city. John and Diana?
Whoa, scary stuff. All right, Devin Dwyer in Washington for us this morning. Thanks.
To you is if it's coming in 3 weeks, pray.